phi n, and this becomes minus 1 by n, and this become minus n, that means minus 2 by n. So this becomes 1 by pi. This is 2j sine pi n. Now you can further simplify it. Let's try question number 5.5. बंद कर दिया, बंद कर दो, बंद है। Use Fourier transform synthesis equation to determine the inverse Fourier transform of x e raised power j omega mod of x e raised power j omega j angle of x e raised power j omega, where mod x e j omega is given to be 1, 0, it is 1 in the frequency range, and 0 and angle x e j omega is given to be minus 3 by, then we have to find out what is the signal corresponding to x e j omega. Now, if the signal corresponding to this is x n, then we know x n over any frequency length pi, I am just taking the fundamental one, x e j omega e raised power j omega d omega. Now we have to substitute for this, keeping this in mind. X e j omega is mod of x e j omega into angle of this. So this becomes 1 by 2 pi minus pi to pi mod of x j omega angle of x e j omega e raised power minus j omega n d omega. Now this becomes 1 by 2 minus pi to pi, this is given to be 1, and in this range, that means from minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, it is 1, and the angle is this e raised power j omega n d omega. Now you can combine these two to obtain 1 by 2 pi minus pi by 4 to pi by 4 e raised power n minus 3 by 2 j omega d omega. to this we can integrate this with respect to omega to obtain e raised power j n minus 3 by 2 omega upon j n minus 3 by 2 1 by 2 pi, this is 1 by 2 pi, and this is to be evaluated at minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. Now you can simplify this. You can simplify this and you will get you simplify this, then you should get sine pi by 4 n minus 3 by 2 upon pi n minus 3 by 2. This will be your xn. Let us do the problem number 5.6. Which says, given the Fourier transform of a discrete time signal DTFT as x e raised power j omega, then we have to find out the part A, the Fourier transform of a signal x1n, which is obtained as x of 1 minus n plus x of minus 1 minus n. Now let's use the property of Fourier transform to do this problem. We know that if Fourier transform of xn is this, then the Fourier transform of x of minus n will become x e raised power minus j omega. Now signal x1n can be written as x of minus n plus 1, and this can be written as x of minus 1 minus 1. That means x minus, and this can be written as x of minus n plus 1. So this signal is further x of minus n is being delayed by 1. So we apply delay property. X of minus 1 you know, then from here x of minus n minus 1, this will be using delay property, minus j omega x e raised power minus j omega. And here it is the advancing x of minus n plus 1. We are advancing this signal. It will be e raised power j omega x e raised power minus j omega. So DTFT of x1n becomes e raised power minus j omega x of e raised power minus j omega plus e raised power j omega x of e raised power minus j omega, which can be simplified as e raised power minus j omega plus e raised power j omega x of e raised power minus j omega. That means twice cosine of omega x e raised power minus j omega. Then next part. Part B. Part B is if dt f t of a discrete time signal election is given to this, then what is discrete time signal, discrete time Fourier transform of a signal x to n, which is by 2. If discrete time Fourier transform is this, then discrete time Fourier transform of conjugate of n. If the signal is real, then you get this, or we can just find it out. Let's try to find out what is the dtft of this. Then xn e raised power minus j omega n summation over n. This is the discrete time Fourier transform of xn. Now we have to find out its conjugate signal. Let's take complex conjugate of both sides. Then this becomes now if I replace n by using this definition, let's try to find out the complex conjugate of discrete time Fourier transform of this. Then from defining equation, this becomes this. Then this can be written as complex. Then this is minus n, this is plus n. So the dtft of this becomes e raised power j omega complex. So that means x complex e raised power no. Let's substitute here n as minus m. So this becomes m equal to infinity, m equal to minus infinity. X of minus n becomes m, and this becomes minus j omega m complex. Now if I add a series either from end or from beginning, summation is same. So using that argument, we can say that this is m, the coefficient of minus m is e raised power j omega. So this becomes x e raised power j omega complex, which is x complex e raised power j omega. So now the dtft of this, if I define as e raised power j omega, this becomes plus x e raised power j omega by 2. This you can further simplify. The complex conjugate of this is this. That means twice real of x e j omega by 2 and this cancels. So real of x e j omega. The last part, which is part C. Part C of this says that if the Fourier transform of action is x omega, then what is the Fourier transform of a signal x3n, which is obtained as n minus 1 square xn. This signal can be written as n square minus 2n plus 1 xn. That means n square xn minus 2n xn plus xn. Now, if Fourier transform of xn is x omega, then we know the Fourier transform of n xn is j d by d omega x omega. So, by the same argument we can write that the Fourier transform of this becomes j d by d omega into j d by d omega x omega. And of here this is 2 j d by d omega x omega plus x omega. J square is minus 1 and you can get, once we know x omega, we can simplify this. Now let us move to some other type of problem. Say these are some fundamental problems which are quite useful to you. You must practice yourself also, and if you want to ask any specific problem to be done, please let me know in the next class. It says that the LTI system with impulse response H1n, which is given to be 1 by 3 raised power n un, is connected with another system with impulse response H2n. So this will be the total, say, impulse response Hn. Now he says that frequency response of this Hn the discrete time Fourier transform of this Hn is given to be minus 12 plus 5 e raised power minus j omega divided by 12 minus 7 e raised power minus j omega plus e raised power minus j 2 omega. Then it says determine S to N. We have to determine S to N. Now let's simplify this block first. Sn. Will be a sum of these two, H1n plus H2n. Now, let's take a discrete time Fourier transform of both sides. Take discrete time Fourier transform of both the sides. To obtain discrete time Fourier transform, this is given, so I am writing this minus 12 plus 5 e raised to the power minus j omega upon 12 minus 7 e raised to the power minus j omega plus e raised to the power minus j 2 omega. Now we have to find out what is the Fourier transform of H1n. This will be 1 upon 1 minus 1 by 3 e raised to the power minus j omega, and then Fourier transform of this I am denoting it by S2 e raised to the power j omega. Now S2 e raised to the power j omega will be minus 12 plus 5 e raised to the power minus j omega upon 12 minus 7 e raised to the power j omega plus e raised to the power minus j 2 omega minus 1 upon 1 minus 1 by 3.